Welcome back to Practice Update. I'm Dr. Farzana Hafizullah. Joining me today is Dr. Timothy Plouad. Dr. Plouad is a medical oncologist at St. Luke's Cancer Institute. How are you? Great to have you back.
Great to be here.
So we're here again, San Antonio Breast Cancer Symposium. I want to know your practice-changing updates, any highlights that you want to tease out and share with our viewership. We'd love to hear.
Well, I think one of the things that we learned here in the last few days is some things not to do.
Yeah, that's right. Very important.
That shortening Herceptin is not a good idea.
Okay.
We need a full year.
Absolutely.
That adding celecoxib to adjuvant endocrine therapy doesn't work. That extending adjuvant zoledronic acid to 5 years as opposed to 2 years only leads to increased toxicity and no benefit. The keynote address today about really utilizing radiation as an immunostimulant to make the tumors hot.
Yes.
And not only you can radiate one lesion and create an immune activated environment for the entire body, which then makes the cancer elsewhere more sensitive to immune checkpoint therapy.
Excellent.
It's a really exciting combination.
Anything else you'd like to highlight from this symposium?
I think the phase 2 data on the anti-TROP2 antibody drug conjugate, which showed some efficacy in heavily treated triple negative breast cancer, is exciting, and we'll await the results of their phase 3 trial, which is ongoing.
Well, wonderful. We are waiting with bated breath with you on that. Until the next symposium, we're happy to have you with us, and we're looking forward to seeing more great work from you.
Thank you.
And to our viewers, thank you again for joining us for this practice update. I'm Dr. Farzana Hafizullah. Join us again soon.